Stay your weapons. I would speak with you, Quinarin. Cursed, not dead. Doomed to exist in this form for eternity. The hostility was necessary. I was bound to an oath. I believe in civility among seasoned warriors, and I find your ear worthy of my words. My claws have rendered the flesh of innumerable foes, but I have never once been felled on the field of battle. I therefore honor name you Quinarin, or Vanquisher in your tongue. Your words do me great honor. My desire to speak with you was born from the result of our battle, Quinarin. I merely wish to respectfully ask a favor of you. For countless years I've roamed the Soul Cairn in unintended service to the Ideal Masters. Before this, I roamed the skies above Tamriel. I desire to return there. I fear that my time here has taken its toll upon me. If I ventured far from the Soul Cairn, my strength would begin to wane until I was no more. I will place my name with you and grant you the right to call my name from Tamriel. Do me this simple honor. Trivial in your mind, perhaps. I don't require an answer, Quinarin. Simply speak my name to... There was a time the Dovah roamed the sky. I began to explore what the Dovah called Elok Dilan. The ancient forbidden art that you call necromancy. The Ideal Masters assured me that my powers would be unmatched. In return, I was to serve them as a keeper until the death of the one who calls herself Valerica. I discovered too late that the Ideal Masters favor deception over honor. They had control of my mind, but fortunately they couldn't possess my soul. Free? No. The Soul Cairn has become a part of what I am. I only hope that you will allow me the precious moments of time there through your call.
Let's just say, how in the name of Zenithar was I to know the ingredients were phony? Do I look like some... Now double-cross and necromancy.
No place for you. you've done.
Can't I just die?
This is no place for you. Yes, how may I... I'm afraid I won't be able to help you with the scrolls any longer, my lord. Please, do not be angry with me. I'm afraid in my haste to read the first scroll, I neglected the time I needed to prepare. As you can see from my bandages, it's not that I am unwilling, it's that I am physically unable. Oh, please, my lord, please, forgive me. If only such a miracle existed, I'd overcome the impossible in order to secure it, if it meant pleasing you. Although I would gladly die by your hand, perhaps I could offer an alternative way to read the scrolls. Oh, thank you, my lord. Thank you. Scattered across Tamriel are secluded locations known only as Ancestor Glades. Performing the ritual of the Ancestor Moth within the glade should provide the answers you seek. It involves carefully removing the bark from a canticle tree, which will in turn attract Ancestor Moths to you. Once enough of the moths are following, they'll provide you with the second sight needed to decipher the scrolls. In keeping with tradition, every moth priest is... From what I saw in the vision, the Elder Scroll which foreshadows the defiance of the gods with the blood of mortals is the key to the prophecy. Fortune smiled upon me.
We reach Ancestor Glade soon.
God might get nervous. A man approaches with his weapon drawn.
Thank you. someone there?
I will send you off inside.
Our client is quick.
thought I lost you there.
Who's there?
Bow. Do you know where we can find it? Then it's almost over. Where is this Darkfall cave? Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down. Not much. As far as I know, though, it's never been held by a vampire. That would be a new one. Where'd you come from?
Them and look. Okay, let us search them.
Come forward. You have nothing to fear here. I am Knight Paladin Gellibor. Welcome to the Great Chantry of Auriel. Auriel, Auriel, Alkosh, Akatosh, so many different names for the Sovereign of the Snow Elves. I prefer Snow Elf. Those twisted creatures you call Falmer, I call the Betrayed. Of course, you're here for Auriel's bow. I can help you get it, but first, I must have your assistance. I need you to kill Archcurate Vertha, my brother. The kinship between us is gone. It was the Betrayed. They did something to him. I just don't know why Auriel would allow this to happen. They swept into the Chantry without warning, and began killing everyone without pause. The Chantry was a place of peaceful worship. They slaughtered everyone, and stormed the Inner Sanctum, where I believe they corrupted Vertha. He's alive. I've seen him, but something's wrong. He never looks as though he's in pain or under duress. He just stands there and watches, as though waiting. Leaving the way shrines unguarded would be violating my sacred duty, and an assault on the Betrayed guarding the Inner Sanctum would only end with my death. Yes, let me show you. This structure is known as a way shrine. They were used for meditation and for transport when the Chantry was a place of enlightenment. Prelates of these shrines were charged with teaching the mantras of Auriel to our initiates.
What's that basin in the center signify?
Once the initiate completed his mantras, he'd dip a ceremonial ewer in the basin at the way shrine center and proceed to the next way shrine.
So these initiates had to lug around a heavy pitcher of water. Marvelous. How long would they have to do that?
Well, once the initiate's enlightenment was complete, he'd bring the ewer to the Chantry's inner sanctum. Pouring the contents of the ewer into the sacred basin of the sanctum would allow him to enter for an audience with the Archcurate himself.
All that just to end up dumping it out? Makes no sense to me.
It's symbolic. I don't expect you to understand.
So, let's get this straight. You need to do all that nonsense to get into the temple so you can kill your brother and claim Auriel's bow.
I know how it all sounds. But if there was another way, I'd have done it long ago. The only way to get to my brother... The first lay at the end of there are five caves. But before I send you on your... Once you've looked, they will allow you to draw... Otherwise, all I can do now is grant you my hopes for a safe journey.